enjoy Tenta and let's go to the castle, of course. I'm headed straight for the castle. They wanna make me their queen. Welcome. I hope you will learn something and let's have some fun. Okay, so first of all, Happy New Year. I believe it's still January, so as long as January hasn't ended, I can still wish you a Happy New Year. Happy New Year.
So
please do subscribe, of course. We're starting to take this a little bit too seriously. Not a little bit, we're starting to take this seriously. So please do subscribe, like the video, notifications. You know that jazz. Yes, yes, yes. 2021. The long-awaited 2021 for some of us who are in Zambia. We know how important 2021 is. And I think for everybody, we were all looking forward to 2021. And it's like 2 weeks in and everybody's just like, okay. We're still on the like, maybe, okay. Just maybe, things are gonna change, okay. But anyway, regardless, happy 2021. Okay, so in this video, I wanted to share with you some of the things that you should consider as you are making your vision boards, your resolutions, your plans, all those things that people normally do at the beginning of the year. I'm not sure this year if we're really doing resolutions or vision boards anymore after 2020, because 2020 was dramatic, tragic. I think most of us have like 2020 PTSD. Anyway, regardless, there's still people like me who still want to be organized, who want to have a plan, who want to have a schedule to stick to, things to achieve, goals and all that. Yes, of course. So this are some of the suggestions that I am hoping will help you and me, of course, because I am also adhering to these suggestions of what you need to think of as you plan it, as you plan your year, as you plan your month, as you make plans, basically, as you make resolutions, as you put up your goals, as you do that very, very beautiful, beautiful vision board like mine. So let's just get right into that. Okay, so first thing I would say is have perspective. Perspective is that hope. I would say that even if right now we are in the COVID crisis, I'm living in a country where we have like a total lockdown, everything's closed, but it's all about before you make your plans, as you make your plans, before you make that vision board, have perspective of hope, foresight. Your mind's eye is your perspective. So have that perspective of, okay, I want to be able to do this, this, and this, and this, and this. That hope. That even as I am planning to do this, I will try my best. I will strive so much to achieve it. Number two, I think. Another thing that you need to consider is always remember that life happens. As you plan, as you buy your planners, as you use your 2021 planners, your schedule books, your Google calendars, your whatever calendar you're using, always remember that life happens. With the COVID crisis, I think this is more real than ever, because before you would be like, okay, I need to leave room for disappointment in this and this and this, but now it's like life happens and you can't control it. Today it's corona, tomorrow it will be zombies, who knows? So have that in the back of your mind as you're setting your plans, as you're making your vision board, that life happens. And it happens just like... Number three. Another thing I would say is look at your current situation. That's your starting point. As you make your plans, be realistic about it. For example, let's say you want to save so much. Starting from now, it's your plan to start saving. So look at, first of all, how much are you earning? What are your expenses like? Are there some things that you can cut out, that you can live without? for you to be able to save. So look at your current situation, face reality before you dream that big dream, so that it is something that is achievable. It is achievable, it's realistic. Look at your current situation. Another thing to remember as you make your plan, you plan your vision board, is you will have to change to achieve some of those things. You will have to change to do the plans that you have. An example I can give on this is, for example, if you want to start working out, you want to start exercising, you want to lose weight, you want to gain weight, like that whole fitness arena is a very good example of you have to change to achieve some of these plans of yours, because it's either you have to start eating properly, you have to start exercising more, you have to start, there'll always be an aspect of change for most of your plans anyway. Another thing is, do not be so hard on yourself. I mean, life is already hard. It's so hard. We're dealing with so much already. So you make plans to serve as a guide, of course, of things that you want to do, you want to achieve. But don't be so hard on yourself if it's like September or October and you're still not where you thought you would be. I mean, remember 3 suggestions ago? Life happens. Don't be so hard on yourself if it's not happening or if it's not going the way that you would want. I mean, live life, chap. Another thing I would suggest is, don't be limited and don't be afraid to dream big. As much as your reality or your current situation may look like, okay, right now on this budget, I gotta take a vacation to the Bahamas, don't let that stop you from dreaming. Don't let that stop you from going like, you know what, just maybe. Remember, life happens, and life doesn't just happen in the negative. Positive things do happen too. Right now it might look like you are far away from achieving that thing that you've always wanted, and tomorrow it might be, you're there. Don't be afraid to dream big. So thank you so much, you guys. I hope these tips were helpful as you write your resolutions, or as you adjust your resolutions. If you're adjusting your 2020 resolutions, you're making your vision boards, you're having plans, I hope these tips will help you have effective plans and will help you have a proper guide as you go on, stick to your schedule. Okay, so those are my tips, those are my suggestions. I hope they'll be helpful to you, and if you do have other suggestions, please don't feel shy to let me know in the comments, and don't feel shy also to follow me on Instagram to see my adventure vlogs. Yes, so please don't forget to subscribe, like this video, share it with somebody, and I will see you the next